What is the future of digital twins? And how might they revolutionize industries? I'm Asma Lafouge, and you are watching The Twin Talks. To answer these questions, we are joined today by Dr. Prith Banerjee, CTO at Ansys. Prith is responsible for leading the evolution of Ansys technology strategy and championing the company's next phase of innovation and growth. Thanks for joining us, Prith.
Thank you very much, Asma. Looking forward to this.
My first question for you, Prith, is what emerging technologies or methodologies do you see shaping the future of digital twins?
Absolutely. So a digital twin is basically a virtual model of a physical world asset and to which you have some connections, right, through IoT sensors and so on. So the key thing in a virtual model is that virtual model has to run fast as the data you are getting from the physical asset, right? Because this is how digital twins work. So in terms of sort of key emerging technologies, the simulation technologies that you have for simulating digital twins has to be fast enough that it can run it at the speed of the physical asset. And so the emerging technologies are the core technology is what we call reduced order models, but it's basically it's a broader area of AI. Everybody's talking about Gen AI and AI and machine learning and so on. That's at the core of what we do. The normal simulation methods that we use finite element, finite volume methods. They can take thousands of hours to run. And so we accelerate the time by using AI ML, Gen AI techniques, and reduced order models to make it go super, super fast. So that is an extremely important part of technology. The other important part of the technology is how we combine reduced order modeling with data-based analytics to do what is called hybrid digital twins. So those are two of the most important technologies that we bring to bear to digital twins.
How do you envision the evolving role of digital twins in enhancing product design, development, and lifecycle management?
Absolutely. And so what digital twins have typically been used in the operational environment. You have an asset like a switchgear or a transformer, and you put some IoT sensors on the transformer, and you pull data from that asset, and you try to do prediction of how this asset will perform in the future, right? Now, so that is what is called digital twin in the operational mode. Increasingly, people are using it in the digital twin in the design phase, digital twin in the development phase or manufacturing phase, and so on. So these days, people are actually using digital twins in the entire product lifecycle, from design to development to manufacturing to operations and end of life. And across all industries, from industries starting from aerospace and defense, where you're trying to do a digital twin of an airplane or a digital twin of an airplane jet engine, to say automotive areas, so digital twin of a car or an engine of a car, or a tire of a car, or in the manufacturing area, digital twins of entire manufacturing plants with the different sort of machines or the entire manufacturing plant, or digital twin in the healthcare area, where you're doing sort of digital twin of the human heart or the human body, or sort of digital twins of pharmaceutical plants and so on. And so digital twins have been used in all industries and in different phases of our product lifecycle.
And how can digital twins leverage real-time data to drive predictive maintenance and performance optimization?
So the way, as I said in my definition, a digital twin is a virtual model of a real-world asset that is connected. So typically, you will have an asset like, as I say, switchgear, a transformer, a car, a jet engine, or whatever, putting IoT sensors on it and try to pull data from that, right? And so you have the normal behavior of that asset. And then before this asset fails, it starts giving abnormal signals, right? Just like the human, we humans, we have a normal behavior, right? And a normal temperature is 98 degrees. But before we fall sick, we give a fever. So our temperature goes up to 100 degrees, 102 degrees. If you could monitor the human temperature, that can predict that Prith is about to fall sick, right? And so essentially that is what is going on with predictive analytics, right? With putting real-time data, and you take sort of the normal behavior of the signals, you put it through a time series database, and then you look at the abnormal behavior. And as soon as you see a difference, you say, hey, I predict that it's going to fail. So using that, people have been doing digital twins for predictive maintenance. But nowadays, what we are doing is we are combining that predictive maintenance with hybrid digital twins, where we combine the database, the data analytics, with simulation-based digital twins with reduced order models. And through that, the accuracy of the predictive maintenance is much, much better.
And what challenges do you anticipate in the adoption of digital twins, and how can companies overcome them to realize their full potential?
So the main thing about a digital twin is you have to get data from that asset, right? So suppose you have the asset is sitting inside a factory, right? And you're trying to pull data from that asset to the cloud, right? So many times a customer is not willing to pull data from inside the factory to the cloud and so on, because they're worried about data privacy and security and so on, right? Oh, well, if I'm pulling the data, what if somebody hacks into it and so on? So if you were to gather the data only within on-premise, that's one set of things. But if you're trying to do the full benefit of digital twins, you're trying to pull the data, doing the analytics on the cloud, you will have to pull data from inside the machine to the cloud. And people are worried about data privacy, security, and so on, right? So that is a real challenge. Second challenge is with CRISPR digital twins, right? For a hybrid digital twin to really work, you need to have the simulation model of that asset. For that, you need to have the original CAD design of that equipment. So suppose you have a manufacturing equipment in a plant, right? You may not have access to, you may have a injection molding machine, but you may not have the original CAD design of the injection molding machine in order to simulate the injection molding machine, right? So these are some of the practical challenges. You may not have access to all the CAD models and therefore detailed simulation models to really drive those reduced order models to get digital twins. So those are a few things. The other thing is sort of interoperability of information, right? So sometimes you have simulation models from one tool, from one company and so on. And so interoperability is another challenge. So the three challenges are data privacy and security. Second is inadequate access of the original CAD models of the assets that you have. And the third is sort of interoperability of designs and simulations in an organization.
And finally, how do you envision Ansys staying at the forefront of digital twin innovation? And what strategies is the company employing to address the evolving needs of its customers in this space?
So Ansys is the leading simulation provider for all our customers, right? We have strong solutions for fluid simulation with our tool called Fluent. We have strong solutions for electromagnetic simulation with HFSS and Maxwell. We have strong solutions for mechanical simulation, structural simulation with Ansys Mechanical and LS Dyna. Strong solutions for semiconductor simulation with Radar. So we have and strong solutions for optical and photonic simulation with Lumerical. So we have the different physics and we have the leading sort of simulation tools in each of the physics areas. What we have is a key technology to take those detailed physics solvers and automatically build reduced order models from those physics, from reduced order model from the fluids physics, reduced order models from the mechanical physics, reduced order models from the semiconductor physics and so on. So that's one. The second thing is we have tremendous capability in multi-physics interactions. So fluid structure interactions, fluid structure electromagnetics and so on. So we are the leading provider of the individual physics, the leading provider of multi-physics, and the leading provider of reduced order models. On top of it, we have now got a lot of capabilities in AI. We just launched a tool called SimAI, which is a cloud-based platform for leveraging Gen AI techniques to accelerate simulation. And we are and using those kind of AI techniques, we are able to combine the reduced order models with AI models and deliver these hybrid digital twins. So we at Ansys, being the leading providers of simulation, leading providers of multiphysics, of ROMs, and of AI, we are uniquely positioned to drive innovations in the digital twin area.
Thank you so much, Prith, for being part of this special edition of the Twin Talks.
Thank you so much, Asma. Take care.